All right, we had a hard frost a week or so ago.
Yep.
So now it's early, about 7th or 8th of November. You're getting your first, you're getting your harvest done.
Mm-hmm.
You're about halfway done with it. Anything that you've noticed so far?
Well, so far I've noticed, especially in the plots that I have in that had no summer harvest at all. Real thick stems, a lot of lignified plant material, maybe even a little less leaf on the lower quarter of the plant.
Of all three species?
Of most all three species, especially in the pearl millet and the sorghum sedan.
So by harvesting in June and July, you've hopefully made the quality better.
Well, hopefully the plants are a little more, a little less mature, especially I've noticed tillering. In all three species, pearl millet, sorghum sedan, and grain sorghum, there's a lot more individual plants, a lot more tillering that occurred in the plots that were harvested once or twice over the summer months.
So that maybe give you thinner stems then, possibly?
I say thinner stems, more potential leaf material. Of course, we'll have some smaller grain heads in the grain sorghum, but it'd be pretty impressive if we could almost match the grain yield, especially in grain sorghum, of the harvested once over the summer and not harvested at all over the summer.
Because you didn't make it on the third harvest, it didn't make grain on your grain sorghum.
It hardly did. The frost came in. We had a late frost, of course, but yes, it didn't quite make grain on my August harvest.
All right. Now, you had a farmer friend come out here yesterday. He called you right afterwards, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He was all excited about it. And actually, that farmer friend told me last year, I was asking him for advice. He said, he told me he didn't think we had enough growing degree units in the year to harvest, to plant grain sorghum especially, harvest it with livestock or simulate it, and then have grain grow back. And we proved him wrong. It's hard to tell the difference in some of these plots of what was never harvested and what was.
Especially like your grain sorghum.
Especially the grain sorghum.
Because we talked about that they already had a root system.
Yep.
When you harvest it, so it's not like planting them July 1. It just set them back maybe a week or two.
Exactly. They already had a root system to pull nutrients and water, especially in this dry year. That's what's crazy to me. We had very little summer moisture this year. And the regrowth was still that impressive what we are noticing so far. So I can't wait to really compare the treatments to one another and see what the actual biomass differences are.
And you're also going to be looking at forage quality.
Especially on the quality side, looking at our food protein, especially in our how much lignin is there in material, mm-hmm. kind of comparing leaf material especially, comparing that to stem ratio.
At least the stem ratio.
The stem ratio and seeing what the quality differences are even amongst an individual, like between grain sorghum treatments,
mm-hmm.
seeing what the differences is.
Now, are you, last time I think you were convinced that maybe we could start grazing this in the summer and then stockpile our tall fescue. Are you still thinking about that?
I am, especially looking at it now after this frost. My pastures back home with fescue, they're still as green as can be after that frost, and all the plant material here is pretty well, it's brown.
But it's still fairly good though.
Oh, it's still, the nutrients are there.
Mm-hmm.
For sure, it's just not. It might not be as palatable or appealing to say, to livestock.
Could you plant a perennial crop in between these sorghums? You think so? You have best of both worlds, like a tall fescue.
That might be a possibility. Something to definitely look more into to see. You might have to widen the rows, but then you might have. And of course, that opens a whole other conversation about weed control amongst it. But maybe you plant it to an already existing stand of say fescue. That will kind of keep like the cockabird weeds down and water hemp's, and that might bring the best of both worlds, maybe.
Because broadleafs is your issue usually in this type of system.
Broadleafs for sure.
All right, so you gonna measure crude protein, lignin,
NDF, ADF, all the above.
Get all those good, and you still expect this might be a little bit short on protein.
That's yes,
for lactating animals.
Lactating animals, and maybe even. For it almost might meet maintenance requirements.
Okay.
But even in previous stuff that we have done back home, it's still lacking a little bit of protein, just a little bit, where you might consider throwing in some soybean meal or even whole soybeans in moderation.
Okay. Now, something that the farmer mentioned, you know, sheep will not go out in something tall.
No, they will not.
But when you've cut it in July, it's quite a bit smaller, like your pearl millet and your sorghum sedan.
It's about half the height, really. I mean, it's almost head height compared to quite a bit taller.
Now, would that work with them then, the small ruminants?
It would definitely be better. Of course, I mean, sheep, their heads probably about waist high, really. And even in grain sorghum, they might being a little am, but I can in the sorghum sedan, I mean, there's leaf material all the way up here, way above where they could ever reach it, and it'll only become available if they knock it over or push it over, and then that gets into the issue of, well, now it's in the mud.
Oh, sure.
And is it less palatable now in the winter months compared to grain sorghum with all the leaves being a lot lower to the ground to where it's more accessible to them. So accessibility is definitely something that would be a
now, cattle would be fine with this.
Cattle would definitely, they'll run right through it all the way to the end of the fence.
Yeah, they're fearless on something like this.
Compared to small ruminants, quite a bit less.
Now, you are going to measure grain yield on the grain sorghum.
Yes, we're going to compare the yield to see what the impacts were of grazing.
So could you harvest the grain from the grain sorghum and still graze them?
Well, that's a possibility to increase the expense of the operation by bringing a combine harvester. Mm-hmm. Into it, but yes, you still could potentially combine the grain sorghum for as a grain crop, and then turn your livestock in to nibble on what was left behind and all the leaf material.
But then you'd really be in a protein deficient system.
Oh, quite a bit.
Then you'd have to have some supplementation. All right. Well, good luck on the rest of this harvest. We look forward to the results.
Me and you both. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, Will.